हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ आवर 10th लेक्चर. दिस लेक्चर इज़ बेस्ड ऑन बायस्ड और परसेंटेज डिफरेंशियल रिले. इन लास्ट लेक्चर यू हैव स्टडीड और यू हैव गॉन थ्रू डिफरेंशियल प्रोटेक्शन. जनरली डिफरेंशियल प्रोटेक्शन रिले मीन्स द रिले ऑपरेट्स व्हेन द फेजर डिफरेंस बिटवीन टू और मोर इलेक्ट्रिकल क्वांटिटीज एक्सीड द प्रीसेट वैल्यू. दिस यू नो. The electrical quantity may be voltage or current, and based on that may be, we have two principles, circulating current principle or voltage balance principle. But mostly voltage based relays are not preferred. We used to prefer current based differential protection, or we used to prefer circulating current principle. A protection based on circulating current principle, that means current based differential protection, but it has certain limitations. What are that? Let's see. As we know, in differential protection we require two identical CTs. That means the CT ratio of two CTs must be match. Okay. Also, identical. If we require two identical CTs, that means we require the saturation characteristics of both CT should be equal, or it should be identical. Also, they must have equal burden or identical burden. But in practice, this is not possible. No two CTs are identical. So because of this, it causes spill current to flow in a relay operating coil. Also, extension cable resistance causes relay to maltrip or nuisance trip. These are the certain limitations of differential protection. Then next questions come in our mind, how to solve this problem. So in order to avoid these percentage differential protection or biased differential protection can be used. Now we'll switch over to the biased differential protection. What is this biased differential protection? It is also called as percentage differential protection. So in percentage differential protection, as we know, this we have operating coil or operating magnet and electrical then restraining element. So this restraining coil is divided into two halves. Two halves. Here induction type bias differential relay is shown. Okay, here you can see this is your restraining element, this is your operating element. So this restraining coil is divided. Okay, if you consider this is one first terminal, second terminal and third terminal, in between first and second this coil is connected and is given to this operating element. So this is some certain winding on this side and certain winding on this sides. Okay, these are the equal. Okay, this is induction type bias differential. Okay, now here you can see CTs. Okay, operating coil, as this is your operating element, this is here single coil is there. Okay, while restraining coil is divided into two halves. This restraining coil is divided into two halves, nr by 2, or this is nr by 2. Here it is shown n by 2. In some books it is shown n by 2, in some books this is shown as nr by 2. Nr indicates restraining coil, no indicates operating coil. Okay, so the current will flow like this. This is I1, this is I2. So this will be I2 into n by 2. This will be I1 into n by 2, and this is your, from this it is I1 minus I2. This is biased or percentage differential relay. The percentage differential relay is designed to operate the differential current in terms of its fractional relation with actual current flowing through this circuit. It is used to protect system under current transformer saturation, unequal CTs ratio, nuisance trip, etc. It increases the stability of differential protection relays. So that's why it is used. So how this works to, or how this can be shown, or how this can be seen? Percentage differential current relay. Two coils are there in a relay. One is operating coil, another is a restraining coil. The restraining coil produce force or torque which will oppose the operating coil of the relay. Let's, in next figure you can see this. Let's take N is the number of turns in the operating coil and NR is the number of turns in restraining coil. The connection is made as shown in figure. Look here. This is your restraining coil. This lower one is your restraining coil. This is operating coil. This is our protected equipment. At both side we have CTs connected. This is operating coil. This operating coil you can consider it as K, while this restraining coil is considered as R in this figure. This is limited up to this figure only. Here NR is restraining, NR by 2. That means this restraining coil is divided into two halves, while this operating coil is connected in between. Okay. Current flowing through the operating coil is I1 minus I2 or I2 minus I1, depending on whichever is greater. Okay. In these two coils are placed, an operating coil K carries the differential current, which means I1 minus I2. Another coil is restraining coil R, carries current proportional to I1 plus I2 divided by 2. Because of the coil K is connected in the midpoint of the restraining coil. Here you can see it is connected in the midpoint. Okay. Here it is connected in the midpoint, so that's why it is N by 2, or it may be here it is NR by 2. Okay. Normally current I1 flows in the restraining coil in NR by 2 parts, and I2 current flows another NR by 2 parts. Hence the effective ampere turns will be I1 NR plus I2 NR divided by 2. So it will be NR by 2 in bracket I1 plus I2. That's why we have taken total current through the restraining coil is as I1 plus I2 divided by 2. Under normal condition, the force produced by the restraining coil is greater than the force produced by the operating coil. Therefore, relay does not operate. That means this quantity is greater than this operating quantity, so relay will not operate. During fault condition, the operating force become higher than the restraining force. This is your restraining force, this is operating force. Due to this, relay operating coil trips the mechanism. These characteristics can also be achieved using balanced beam relay. Look here. This is operating coil, this is restraining coil. This restraining coil is divided into two halves. This midpoint is connected to the operating coil. Okay, same structure, only balance beam structure is given. Here it is shown IS1, IS2 instead of I1, I2. Here it is shown as IS1 and IS2. This is operating coil. At normal condition, the differential current in the operating coil is proportional to I1 minus I2. So operating coil is I1 minus I2 or IS1 minus IS2. In some books, depending on the figure, here I have shown. Okay. In some book it is I1 minus I2. In some book it is IS1 minus IS2. Okay. But it is difference of two current, while restraining torque will produce I1 plus I2 divided by 2. Okay. This is your restraining coil. Okay. Percentage differential. Thus, the ratio of differential current to the average restraining current is always a fixed percentage. Therefore, it is called as percentage differential relay. In other words, we can define the bias as the ratio between number of turns of the restraining coil to the number of turns of operating coil. That is, percentage bias is equal to NR upon N0. It may be represented as K. where k is typically from 10 to 40%. So this is your operating coil, this is your operating torque I1 minus I2 is greater than nr minus n0 into I1 plus I2 divided by 2. This is your restraining torque. For a relay to operate, this quantity should be greater than this quantity. Okay. Characteristics of percentage relay or characteristics of bias differential relay. The relay which has constant slope operating characteristics such relay is called as constant slope percentage differential relay. It needs high accuracy current transformer to get good performance of the relay. How the characteristics can be shown? On x-axis it is I1 plus I2 divided by 2, while on y-axis t is operating torque is I1 minus I2. This is operating zone, this is restraining zone, because this part is near to this restraining current. So this part is restraining part, this is part is operating, the operating part. If our fault point lies in this zone, the relay will operate. This is your negative torque region, this is our positive torque region. Okay. Advantage and disadvantage of constant slope relay and increased slope relay. In some of the relay, slope varies as short circuit current increases. Such relays can be called as increased slope percentage relay. Advantages of increasing slope percentage differential relay: it does not need high accuracy class current transformer. Disadvantages of increasing slope differential relay: it have high cost. Okay, so what is this? When slope varies, short circuit current increases. In some relays, slope varies as short circuit current increases. Depending upon the current, this characteristics changes, and it has certain limitations as well as certain advantages. We are generally using constant slope relay. Thank you very much.